would you do? All these things are peer pressure. Don't get me wrong, peer pressure can be good too. Your peers can be pressuring you to do something positive, like something that you want to do but are nervous about. Someone could even be pressuring you to try drugs or alcohol. My goal tonight is to teach you what peer pressure is, its forms, and resistance strategies. A form of negative peer pressure is bullying. Bullying can cause stress and worse embarrassment. Bullying can also be cyberbullying. Cyberbullying is saying something behind someone's back on electronic devices. If you see bullying or cyberbullying happening, you should definitely report it. I know reporting it sounds easy, but it can be very difficult. Imagine yourself in this situation. You just made a few new friends, but later on the playground you see one of them bullying a younger kid. Of course you still want to be their friend, but you feel bad for the other kid. What would you do? Here's my opinion on what I would do. I would find a trusted adult I could tell, figure out a private time and place I could tell them, and find the courage to tell them. Pressure could also be between two groups of people. For example, you're going trick-or-treating with a parent, and you meet up with a friend. You really want to go with your friend, but you don't want to leave your parent alone. What would you do now? Dare. That's what I would do. D-A-R-E stands for define, assess, respond, evaluate. D stands for define the situation. In this case, it would be between family and a friend. A stands for assess. What are your choices? My choices are go with my parent or go with my friend, or I'll go together. R stands for respond. Make a choice. I would ask if we could all go together. E stands for evaluate. Did you make the right decision? I think I did. I got to go with my friends and my parent. Do you think I made the right decision? If someone was pressuring you to try drugs or alcohol or smoke, you would have a problem, because obviously they don't know what these things can do to you. For example, there are 75,000 alcohol-related deaths in the U.S. each year. More than 400,000 Americans die from tobacco-related causes each year. Alcohol also slows down the brain and body. Some side effects may include loss of coordination, poor judgment, memory loss of self-control, or slow reflexes. You could also explain that smoking causes heart disease and lung cancer. If informing them doesn't work, there are more resistance strategies to help you. You could change the subject or give an excuse. If those don't work, you could tell them the truth. For example, you could say, I know what drugs can do to you, and I don't want to throw my life away. I don't need you to either. Another resistance strategy you can do is just simply walk away. If none of those change their mind or free you from the situation, don't give up. Just keep trying. No matter what, don't give in. And definitely don't say okay. In some cases, your life depends on it. You are the only one who can make decisions for yourself. Just because someone is forcing you to make a decision, it doesn't mean you have to do it. That person is probably forcing you to do something, was probably speaking to you demandingly. Some signs of a demanding person would be having arms crossed or finger pointing. They are usually either telling you what to do and when to do it, or forcing you to do something and making decisions for you. The opposite of demanding is unsure. Some signs of an unsure person are having bad posture, covering your face with something like hair or hands. The unsure person would be shy and never really sound sure of himself or herself. There's one type of person between demanding and unsure. That is confident. A confident person would be the person you want to talk to. This person would usually have a smile on their face and have good posture. The confident person would make eye contact while talking to you or speak up for his or herself. I think it's very important to always try to be the confident person. Please don't be that person that is encouraging someone to smoke. Don't be that person that's threatening someone. Don't be someone like that. You'll always regret it. You'll make mistakes in your life. Some might even involve peer pressure. When you make mistakes, don't put pressure on yourself. I guarantee you, there will be peer pressure in your life. I hope some of these resistance strategies will help you. I know they will help me. The DARE program has taught me a lot, maybe even saved my life.